Hey friends, it's Brian, and I'm putting together a rotary phase converter so I can run this and that too. So what I got here is a North American Rotary control panel, and I'm going to hook a 10 horsepower three-phase motor that I picked up. I've got a three-phase sub panel that's powered by this, and then the idler motor will draw from these cables off my sub panel in the garage. And the motor I picked up, you know, 10 horsepower motors have gotten kind of hard to find. So this is the 10 horsepower motor. It's rated for 27 amps. It's a 3600 RPM. Yeah, I don't care. I got a good deal on it. It's got a weird shaft. I'm going to cut it off anyway. That's another part of this video. But I need to mount the motor, so I'm going to mount it in this corner. And I'm building a shelf for it. I wasn't going to film all this because I don't know. I don't like to really encourage people to do electric. And if you don't know what you're doing, this is really not the game for you. I'm comfortable working with three-phase and single-phase electricity. Whatever. So, anyway, I've cut the... That's the back piece. And what I'm in the process of doing is kind of laying out the shelf. So let me figure out how deep it needs to be, and I'll get the first piece in here. And then I'm going to cut angle supports to go underneath it to keep it nice and right where I want it. So anyway, let's do it to it. So it's going to be about this deep here. And first things first, I'm going to start a screw in this board. Now, I happen to know there's nothing behind this, but don't go screwing stuff into your walls if you don't know what's behind them. Good enough for now. Thank you. of people would just go ahead and stick something on. I'm going to add reinforcement like this. So let me measure that distance. Sawdust. A couple different ways to do this. We're going to do it like that. Actually, I'm going to do it a different way. Be right back. Okay, so what I've done at this point is I've pre-mitered that, or mitered it to the 45 degree angle that I want. And then I'm going to come back here and figure out where I want this. And now I'm going to go cut that. So what this does is it transfers the load very efficiently from the out edge of this platform down to the wall. And I've used this before. You can put these up here. You can put it up here if you prefer. And that's actually not a bad idea. So we'll go ahead and do that. Actually, you know what? We'll do it the right way. There is a reason to do it. It's not going to give me a whole lot. Actually, that is a good reason to do it from the side. That's kind of hot. There's some weaknesses to screws and shears, but this will be okay. Screws perform best in tensile strength or pulling strength, but for this application, they will be okay. Really solid platform. I need to put a piece of plywood over this. So let me see what I got laying around that's about this size. Okay, so I don't have any pieces of plywood that are the right size. So I've decided to do this with 2x4s. And that's where the first one goes. So we're going to go ahead and secure it down. Thank you.
let's figure out where the second one
goes. I'll be right back.
All right, so
the offset is put the end about here. Doesn't look like much. We'll see. Tricks to get the motor on here without pulling my back out. Okay, so in the category of inappropriate shop tricks for $500, we have using your engine hoist with only one leg extended. There is actually a reason for this, because the legs stick out farther than the boom. Around clearance here. Okay, so next we're just going to kind of slide this back. And that's about what we wanted. It leaves a little clearance back here to draw air, a little clearance to reject air, lots of space to protect me from storing things next to the motor shaft. Now what I'm going to do is anchor it down a little bit. I'm not going to anchor it firmly, though. So, the idea here is just to keep the motor from walking around because it's kind of heavy. That locks it in place. So let's go ahead and get this cover off. It looks like a 5/16 to me. It is not. Is it a whatever the hell this is?
7/16.
All right, let me work out what it is. All right, it is a 3/8. So let's go ahead and open this up and see what we got going on in here. Now, I purchased this motor used from a company here in Houston called Houston Armature Works, and it was a little more expensive than some of the best bargains on Facebook Marketplace, but I have the assurance that they at least went through the motor, replaced the bearings, and that minimizes the odds of getting a motor that has shit bearings in it. So, I've got a knockout here that needs to come out, and then I need to join all my wires together. So I don't know if I have the whip that I need. Let me see if I can find that. All right, folks, so I'm gonna start working on what needs to happen. Miracle that I happen to have some 3/4 inch clamps. Oh, these are, I hate that kind. I've stopped using snap-ins, but these will work. All right, so I got another one that goes up here. Using some material that I already own. Put this away. Thank you. It's better to use strain relief, but it ain't gonna matter on this. This will be just fine. So one of the reasons I do not like snap-ins is that they continue to rotate once they're in. And they're just, they're really an inferior way to attach these. It'll work out in the end, but I don't use these anymore. All right, so that's good. All right, let's go ahead and make these connections. So we'll just kind of clear some stuff out of the way. That can hang down. And first thing we want to do is we want to attach the ground. So that should be more than enough wire. We'll back it out a little bit. I'm using 10-4 SJO or SOO. I don't know which one it is. Doesn't matter. They're both rated for 230 volts. And it's just flexible wire. It's frequently used for extension cords and other cords that are going to be used. It's a very flexible conductor. And I'm using it here because it'll be very tolerant of any vibration or minor movement that occurs. And sorry, all y'all are seeing is my elbow right now. But I need two hands in here. Actually, I'd probably rearrange this camera. Alright, that's better. So next we're going to bring in the three phase connectors for the motor. And this panel is completely unwired, so I'm not paying as much attention to electrical safety as I might with a live, with something that had live voltage on it. And we're going to keep black, red, and then we're going to reuse one of the conductors. So that looks about right there. That gives me a little bit of flexibility. Not the right tool for stripping, but it will work. These are some really interesting lugs. They're look pretty custom. Yeah, that's good. Just trim this off. Now, some guys would just go, yeah, we're going to use widest conductor. And that would be heresy for me as an inspector who calls this out all the time. I just happen to have blue tape because I used to own a building with three-phase power. So I'm going to remark the... yeah, that would have been better if... So I'm going to relabel the conductor so that I know that this is not a neutral. And that's a best practice. And it's also National Electric Code, NFPA 72. I always used to preach to my employees when I had a company with employees that safety takes a second, accidents are instant. Alright, so now we're going to come over here and we're going to decide how much cable do we want. Now we could get by with that. That's more than enough. Let me get some clippers or cutters that will actually shear through this. Pretty impressive for hands work. Okay, so we're going to bring this up through here. Now, we don't want to bring too much wire into this box because there's already a lot going on in here. So that looks like it's more than enough right there. Sometimes that'll be enough, and sometimes it won't. You don't want to cut into this too hard. Normally, scoring it is enough. Okay, so let's see. It is a 3/8. First thing we want to do is we're going to strip off a lot of the ground wire and we're going to bond the motor housing. lot of times you'll have a lug in here. We do not have a lug, so we're going to use one of the housing screws. And then we're going to pull all this over here out of the way. So we can do this. Bit better. All right, so that bonds the motor. And now we need to find 1, 2, and 4. So there's 2. And 1, nope, that's 274. So there's T2 and T4. T2, T4, and looks like T1. So I bought some red. Yeah. These might work. They might not. I'm gonna try one and just see what this looks like. I think this is a little bit small. Seems to be okay. Now, I don't trust that. So I'm going to come in here. No, that ain't going to work. So I'm going to have to trust it. Okay. So next is 285. Eight. Wait a second. Well, I just put 2. Yeah, that didn't work. I guess that was 174. That's exactly what it was. 174. So we'll pull these back out. Strip this one off. And we'll go ahead and strip this one off while we're at it. Alright, so 285. Here's 2, 8, 5. Physics of how electrons flow doesn't really agree with how these connectors work, but it is what it is. All right, so then we should have 3, 9, whatever's left over. So 3, 9, and 6. This is why I can't be an electrician. My hands already hurt, and I'm only working with a handful of wires. I like doing electrical work. I think I'm reasonably good at it. And I juggled the... Oh, wait. Aw, shit. No, this is not how this goes together. Boy, it's good. I'm having trouble reading the label, so don't laugh too hard at me. The label's got some marks on it, and that makes it difficult to understand what's going on. But I've got the motor hooked up wrong, so... All right, so 1 and 7 go together. And 4 stays out. So we're going to change the winding of the motor is what we're doing. Changing it from star to delta. So 4 comes out. And then 2 and 8 So that's 3 and 9 Yeah, so 3, 9 and red. No, blue. And then 2 and 8 go with the middle one. All All right, so then we should have 4, 5, and 6 that get connected together. At this point, everything should be good to go.
And then we bring this down.
First thing I like to do when I'm working in a panel is bond it. But in this case, I'm going to turn all these circuits off that I'm not using, and I'm going to pull them out of my way. Okay, we're just going to tuck these back out of my way. A live panel, but I'm exercising enough caution that I'm okay with it.